Hi, this is Rob Devaney from Adecco Group North America, and this is the October edition of the Workplace Economy. So what were the most notable insights from the September jobs report? Well, this month's report was a bit of a mixed bag, with government jobs and ending census positions making up the vast portion of losses. But the private sector continued its trend of adding jobs, with 64,000 jobs added. And this is the ninth consecutive month of private sector growth, which is fantastic. The temporary job sector continued to show growth. There were 17,000 jobs added. Another sector showing growth were professional and business services, retail, leisure, and hospitality and healthcare. Now, what are other industries gained jobs in September? Healthcare gained 32,000 jobs. Professional and business services gained 14,000 jobs. Temporary gained 17,000 jobs. Legal gained 2,500 jobs, and leisure and hospitality, 38,000 jobs. Were there any surprises with the industries that gained and lost jobs? Well, the public sector is continuing to see a loss in the jobs, and the vast majority, like I said, is going to be the end of the census positions. These losses are being attributed to bringing down the total number as the private sector has continued to add the jobs. But that being said, the private sector will need to add more jobs in order to speed the overall job market situation along. On a national level, manufacturing had a slight job loss, which is not indicative of what we're seeing. At Adecco, this sector is doing very well, and we continue to see the addition of a lot of jobs, particularly in the auto manufacturing positions. Seasonal retail jobs started showing in September, which is generally not seen until October, which is good. And at Adecco, we started to see an uptick in seasonal retail jobs as well. So what else are we seeing here at Adecco? We're still continuing to see a number of clients choose temporary hiring as a staffing plan over permanent hiring for the remainder of 2010. Although we're seeing an increase in permanent placements. As we discussed earlier, we're starting to see the uptick in seasonal hiring as we approach the holidays, and sectors that will most likely feel the direct impact will be retail and will be light industrial. What direction do we see the market going? Well, as the November elections are approaching, one of the main topics is going to be jobs. And with nearly 15 million unemployed Americans, politicians are going to continue to focus on job creation and continue to focus on keeping America competitive, be a competitive place to work. There are many, many people who are skilled and ready to work, and we think once the jobs are available, the economy and consumer confidence will strengthen. So 2010 kicked off with a large amount of growth, and the second half of the year has shown more of a normalizing of the job market and normalizing of the economy. We think the recovery is happening. It just may take a little longer than we initially hoped, and there will be pockets of uneven indicators. We're likely see unemployment continue to increase, but it's more a factor of people just re-entering the job market, and it's not necessarily a negative indicator. So do we have any advice for employers as they prepare for Q4 and year-end activity? We think employers are much more optimistic about 2011 than they were in 2010, and they'll likely account for greater staffing needs than last year. We also think it's important to continue to focus on retaining and developing your talent and invest in them. This is going to pay dividends in the long run, especially as the job market opens up and the war for talent intensifies in 2011. So this is Rob Devaney from Adecco Group North America, and this has been the October edition of the Workplace Economy.